Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to talk about the price to sales ratio and how we can calculate and use the price to sales ratio and explain how you can use it as a beginner. So back when I first started investing in trading, I would look up at all these numbers and figures and not knowing what they mean, how to calculate them, and more importantly, how to use them. So in this video, I'll be explaining about all these things such as what is a price to sales ratio, how to calculate it, and how you can use the price to sales ratio even if you're a beginner. So make sure you stick around to the end of the video because I'll be showing you guys and be going through using live examples of companies and their price to sales ratio. So with that, let's dive right in. Alright, so I'm on my computer. So before we start looking at how to use the price to sales ratio, we need to know what it means. So the price to sales ratio of a company is a valuation ratio. So a valuation ratio is a ratio of a company that we take a look at to help us determine the value of a company. So there are other valuation ratios out there such as the price to earnings ratio that can help us determine the value of a company. So the price to sales ratio is one of such valuation ratios. So the next thing we want to look at is how the price to sales ratio can help us determine the value of a company is to indicate to us the price or value placed on each dollar of a company's sales or revenue. So that is the definition of the price to sales ratio. So next, let's take a look at the price to sales ratio formula. So to calculate the price to sales ratio, we take the current share or stock price of the company divided by its sales per share. So we can find the current share or stock price of companies either by doing a quick Google search of the company's ticker symbol or just typing the company followed by share price. So the next thing we want to find out is the sales per share. So to calculate the sales per share, we have to first find the sales revenue of a company and then dividing it by its total shares outstanding. So for this step, we have to use the data available on the financial website. I'll be going through this process later on in the video using live examples. For now, we need to know that to calculate the price to sales ratio of a company, we take the current share price of a company divided by its sales per share. So now that we know the definition and formula of the price to sales ratio, we want to interpret the ratio. So using the definition and formula that we have just learned, we know that the price to sales ratio is the price amount that investors and traders place on each dollar of a company's sales. So the higher the price to sales ratio, the greater the share price of company that investors and traders place on each dollar of the company's sales. So this means that investors and traders value each dollar of sales by the company at a higher evaluation. So the higher the price to sales ratio of a company, the less fair valued the company is. So when we are valuing companies, we ideally want the companies to have a low price to sales ratio, because this will indicate to us that the company is undervalued. So similar with other financial ratios that we have learned in the previous videos, when we compare the ratios of companies, we want to compare with companies in the same sector and industry to give us a more accurate indication of the valuation of a company. So we want to compare the price to sales ratio of a company with its competitors in the same sector and industry because they are in the same type of business with very similar products and services and therefore similar kinds of sales. Hence, investors and traders can get a more accurate valuation by comparing companies with similar types of sales. So now that we know the definition, the formula, and how to use the price to sales ratio, let's take a look at some companies' price to sales ratio. Okay, so I'm on Google right now. Let's take a look at Alibaba. Okay. So Alibaba, you can see that the share price of Alibaba is $185.49. So that's the share price of the company. So the next thing that we want to calculate is the sales per share of a company. So to do that, we use Finviz, which is a financial website that we key in Alibaba. And you can see that Alibaba has a total shares outstanding of 2.57 billion. So the next thing you want to take a look at is the sales revenue of Alibaba. So to do that, I like to use Reuters. So I'm going to search Alibaba. Okay, so to find the sales revenue of a company, we go to the financials tab, and then we go under the income statement. So as we can see that Alibaba's sales revenue for the year is 376,844 million. So this is all displayed in terms of million. So this is Alibaba's sales revenue. So to calculate the price to sales ratio of Alibaba, we take the share price of Alibaba divided by the sales per share of Alibaba. So let's calculate the sales per share of Alibaba first. So Alibaba's sales revenue for the year is 376,844. So let's calculate 376,844 multiplied by a million, because it's displayed in terms of millions. So 1, 2, 3. Then we divided it by the total shares outstanding. So total shares outstanding is 2.57 billion. So 2.57 billion multiplied by a billion. So a billion is 9 zeros. So it's 1, 2, 3. Okay, so this is the sales per share. So it's 146.63. So to calculate the price to sales ratio, we simply take the current share price of Alibaba, 185.49. So 185.49 divided by its sales per share, which is 146.63. So this is the price to sales ratio of Alibaba, 1.27. So that is how we calculate the price to sales ratio of Alibaba, and we can use this formula to calculate the price to sales ratio of other companies also. So that is how we calculate the price to sales ratio and how we can use the price to sales ratio to evaluate companies. I hope that you have found this helpful and have learned how to interpret and use the price to sales ratio when you analyze companies from now on. If you have liked this YouTube video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below. If you guys would like to see any other financial ratio related videos, let me know in the comment section down below. I might feature one of your questions in my future videos. So, okay, bye guys, to your financial success.